Whether it does make a dent on the nightmarish traffic situation in the metropolis whenever the holiday season rush arrives. For years now, the adjustment of mall hours has easily become one of the go-to traffic ploys of the MMDA. Thus, this time around, some mall owners have requested to be exempted from the said policy, especially if they are not situated near or within the traffic magnet of a thoroughfare that is EDSA. Did the MMDA actually heed this plea? Patrick DeJesus reveals in this report.
It's only Thursday, but many passengers have chosen to head home to their provinces early before the long weekend in anticipation of both the upcoming elections and the All Saints Day holiday, just like Peter, who's traveling to Bulacan.
Naranasan ko kasi rito, mahabang pila po pagkayong mga peak season. Kaya po, maaga na ako para noon eh, maiwasan ko yung mga traffic. Tsaka yung mahirap sumakay.
Earlier, the MMDA conducted inspections at bus terminals along EDSA. Starting tonight, provincial buses will be allowed to traverse EDSA from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m., a practice common during holidays. This measure will be in effect until November 6.
Ngayong Thursday, marami na rin makita natin kahit hindi pa makapal. Pero perhaps mamayang gabi, mas marami ng babiyahe, pati yung mga private vehicles na uuwi ng kanilang probinsya. Marami na rin nung nag-leave bukas para mas diretso yung bakasyon nila. Kaya as early as today, ngayong Thursday, in-implement na ho namin yung aming deployment.
Malaking bagay po sa mga commuter yon, lalo po yung mga uuwi na sa kanilang mga tahanan. Mas mabilis po tayo makakarating. Pag sa EDSA po tayo dadaan, mga 1.5 hours po natitipid natin.
The MMDA also met with mall operators in Metro Manila to discuss preparations for the holiday season. This is in relation to the adjustment in mall hours, which will be from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. starting November 13 to January 8. During the meeting, some malls requested exemptions, especially those not located along the EDSA. According to the MMDA, formal requests will be reviewed.
Unang-una, they must submit a traffic management plan a week before that kung meron silang weekday sale. And pangalawa po, it will be i-inspect ng ating traffic engineering center sa office po ni Director Recio if that would be feasible na pagbigyan sila. So pag-aaralan muna ho yun bago kami magbigay ng exemption sa mga magre-request na mga mall operators.
The adjusted mall hours also consider the welfare of mall employees. Hence, the MMDA will coordinate with the Department of Transportation to extend the operating hours of the MRT and LRT.
Ang bus carousel po ngayon natin sa EDSA is 24/7. Lalong-lalo po sa EDSA, kumbaga sufficient naman po ang ating mass transport and yun nga po, makikipag-coordinate din kami sa DOTR pagdating po sa operating hours ng LRT and MRT to cater lalong-lalo na yung mga nagtatrabaho ng late na lalabas sa mga malls sa pag-adjust ng ating mall operating hours sa different malls dito sa Metro Manila.
The MMDA also convened with the DPWH regarding moratoriums on excavation projects. Flagship government projects like the Common Station at North Avenue, Skyway Extension at Tramo Pasay, C5 South Link, LRT Line 1 Extension, MRT and Subway are exempted. The MMDA will assess other projects requesting exemption.
Depende to sa magiging effects sa traffic. Kung sa evaluation ng thesis, malaki ang magiging epekto sa traffic, hindi namin pagbibigyan yung request nila.
Patrick DeJesus for The Nation.